Welcome in this week Technical Tuesday with NXCAN. Today I will show a couple methods of machining sidewalls in deep cavities. I will focus on simultaneous 5-axis methods only, so I will use Z-level 5-axis operation as first example. Second approach will be to make 3-axis operation and transform it to 5-axis using tilt tool axis option in NXCAN. As third example, I will use 5-axis streamline operation. In first two examples, I will use traditional ball and mill, but for third one, I will use kind of tool which is designed exactly for situations like this. Let's start with Z-level 5-axis. Here is cut area which will be used. As tool tilt direction, I choose away from part, and maximum wall height in this example is around 150 mm. I will skip all other parameters as depth of cut or step over, as this is just an example. Z-level is very simple operation to create. This is our result. Notice that tool is moving simultaneously in 5-axis, starting from top of the part. As second example, I will create very simple 3-axis Z-level operation, which I will transform to 5-axis after that. I'll also use smooth connections for all transfer motions. As you can see here, tool holder is colliding with our part. And this is what I expected, because check tool and holder option is unchecked. I'll leave it as it is, because now I want to transform this operation to 5-axis to avoid these collisions. To do this, I use tilt tool axis option from context menu. I want to use a little more clearance between part and tool holder, and I will leave all other options as they are. After we click OK, NX calculates new toolpath. In Operation Navigator, we can see now that our Z-level operation has status edited. At the visualization, we can now notice that in this case, tool is not moving in 5-axis simultaneous mode all the time, but only when it is necessary to avoid collision. Let's move to next example. What is most important here is the tool. As I said, this kind of tool is designed for finishing operations. What makes this tool so special is the large radius in the cutting area. This allows us to achieve similar or better surface finish using several times larger stepovers comparing to operations using ball end mill. The biggest question is how can we use this tool with an axe? As you can see here, it can't be used in Z-level 5-axis operation. Also, if I want to use tilt tool axis for operation which uses this tool, I get an error. And in log file, we can see that this tool type is not supported. In my case, I will do it with streamline operation. Cut area is the same as in previous examples. I will choose cut direction along this vector. And I will change cut pattern to helical. As projection vector, I use toward drive, which is usually first choice when machining inside of the geometry. Most important here will be tool axis setting. I will use interpolate vector. Interpolate vector option lets me manually define how tool axis should be oriented in some critical places. Between each vector, which I will define here, an axe will automatically interpolate tool axis vector to keep tool axis changes smooth during machining. Let's take a look how I will define these vectors. In my case, 8 vectors should be enough to achieve toolpath which I'd like. Obviously, with this tool shape, we shouldn't start machining from top of the cut area. I can change it by setting start step parameter in trim and extend. And here is final toolpath. At the beginning, tool is tilting only a little, because on top I tilted vectors only for 5 degrees. But as it goes deeper, it will start tilting some more. With this approach, obviously, system will not avoid collisions with tool holder automatically. So it is essential how tool axis vectors were set. To make sure if it is collision free, I will use gouge checker with check tool and holder option active. And the toolpath seems to be collision free. Finally, we can compare how it actually looks with ball end mill and barrel shaped mill. Thank you for watching. See you next Technical Tuesday with NCmatic.